What's up, Friday, friends? We have made it to the end of the week.
Welcome back to LX News Now. I'm Jo Beth DeVera. Today is the first day of October, and it is also the first day of Breast Cancer Awareness Month, which is the deadliest form of cancer for women worldwide. In the United States, about 255,000 women are diagnosed with the disease every year, and 24,000 die from it, according to the CDC. About one in five people with breast cancer are positive for the HER2 gene, which makes breast cancer more aggressive than other types. And yes, although it's not very common here, men can get breast cancer too. Well, now new data on a new drug is offering some hope for those battling the disease. The drug is called Enhertu, and it's being used to treat incurable HER2-positive breast cancer. Researchers say it is significantly more successful at reducing tumor size and keeping the patient alive longer without progression of disease than the current standard of care. So here to give us all the details we need to know about this new drug is Dr. Erika Hamilton, an oncologist at the Sarah Cannon Research Institute. Doctor, we appreciate your time today. Now, this is a topic that actually hits home for me because I lost my aunt to breast cancer a few years ago. So tell us more about this new drug and how was it studied?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm sorry to hear that. Trastuzumab deruxtecan, or Enhertu, is one drug in a new class of medications called antibody drug conjugates. And that's a way to get chemotherapy just to the cancer cells by a honing mechanism called an antibody. It's advantageous because it targets cancer cells and leaves the rest of the body alone, which translates to less side effects for patients.
That sounds wonderful. How does it differ from the current standard of care for breast cancer patients?
Previously, we've really been using chemotherapy and then separately antibodies. These two drugs weren't fused together. And so by fusing them together and really targeting the chemotherapy just to those cancer cells, mm-hmm. we can put more active, stronger chemotherapy on that molecule and still spare healthy cells. So that's why we really are seeing great strides with this new class of compounds.
So when is it administered and how is it administered in a breast cancer patient?
This is an IV infusion that patients get every 3 weeks. It was already approved for patients that had third line and beyond incurable breast cancer, but this new study, DESTINY-Breast03, tested the molecule against our standard second line regimen. So kind of moving this molecule up earlier in a patient's course. And what we saw was about a year and a half improvement in how long it took before the cancer grew on this molecule. So really an improvement of 18 months longer that the disease was under control without any cancer growth.
Are there any side effects to the drug?
There are. We see side effects from cancer drugs such as fatigue. We can sometimes see hair loss. One of the unique side effects from this drug that we've been very closely watching is lung inflammation. And what was very reassuring in this newer study compared to the study we saw several years ago is now with more recognition and experience giving the drug that we were able to cut down that serious lung inflammation to less than 1%, 0.8% of patients. So that was reassuring as well.
Yeah. Also, I'm curious, what makes HER2 positive breast cancers more aggressive than the other types of breast cancer?
Yeah, so HER2 is a growth factor receptor. So it's a protein that's present on those cell surface that makes them grow faster and makes them more aggressive. But it's also the reason that we can target these with special drugs. So this used to be a type of cancer that we saw very poor outcomes. And over the past decade, really, our outcome, cure rate, and how long patients with HER2 positive incurable breast cancer live has improved.
Awesome. Okay. So is this available only in the U.S. and, you know, do patients just ask their doctor about it if they want this treatment?
So right now it's only available for patients that have incurable metastatic disease. Okay. It is approved in other countries as well. So we anticipate seeing a label change, moving this up earlier from third line and beyond to second line. This drug's also in clinical trials now, not only in the first line setting, but also in patients that do have curable breast cancer to see if we can improve outcomes with this drug there as well.
Yeah, definitely some promising and hopeful news for those battling the disease. Dr. Erika Hamilton, we appreciate you for coming on the show and talking about this.
Thanks so much for having me.
We'll be right back.